Hello, my brothers and sisters on the Dragon's Path. My name is Tim Heijen, and I believe in dragons. And I believe that there are a lot of dragons in this forest. In the past few years, I just made it a portal for the dragon realms. It's just an astral projection that you can get here that is not normal. That is just so powerful that all the dragons can come here and be welcome. But I just want to talk about something else. My dragon, let me explain to you something about my dragon, my guardian next to me, is... My guardian is strict, very strict. When I was 18 years old, my guardian said, here and now, everything must change. And so I fell on my knees, my knees. I was at 8 years before, and just one day, my dragon manifested before me, and I just believed in dragons from then on. And that was beautiful, because my dragon is beautiful. It's just too beautiful. But later I found out that it was more like a mother figure, a motherly figure. And that she put her wing over me, and I did not want that, because I was not worthy of that. And then I pushed the dragon away, but it didn't actually happened, because the dragon just keep coming back, and it was just in my mind, the dragon must keep talking to it. And so I just accepted my path, and then I came to the dragon's realms for 5 months, even if it just felt like just 5 minutes. So, but the feelings I have for the dragon is just, for my guardian, is just a motherly feeling that I have for actually her. In the beginning, actually, it felt more like a he, but it's just shifting all the time. The energy of the gender energy is just shifting all the time, just the same as me. My energy inside of me is more female than I thought. It made me actually a bit more feminine. I'm just in a tornado of energies, and it was very confusing. But a lot of brothers and sisters have a sexual relationship with the dragon, a lot of them, and I understand where it is coming from, because this energy inside of us is draconic, and this draconic energy is actually in the old times they said the dragon was a god or goddess of just that they can have children very easily. Fertility, that's it. And they had sex a lot. That is what I understood from this. And if you can feel this energy inside of you growing and growing, of course this urge will be growing and growing as well. And a lot of people, a lot of brothers and sisters have this as their main issue on their dragon's path, that they feel this sexual attraction for the dragon. Not per se their guardian. Like I said, my guardian is my like my mother. Of course I cannot think of something like that, but it doesn't mean that you don't have the energy, and this energy wants something else. Also a draconic body, a draconic energy. Why do spirits even think about sex? It remains with them. It remains. It keeps. It's just inside of them. It just remains with it. Like a witch, a normal witch, is also a lot of about sex magic and things like that. Because spirits keep them, keep this with them. This energy is remaining with them. It's a lot of energy that you can emit with sexual energy. And this is no different with the dragons. This can be that you have this as well. Not everyone has this. Most of the people actually have this based on the mother or fatherly or mere brother or sisterly figure that is beside them. That is the reason why some guardians can come to you and be there with you as your guardian, because they are relatives of each other. You are a relative of them inside of you. That is because it's not a sexual relationship, it's purely because they are relatives. You know this guardian somehow inside of your mind. You know your dragon before, from somewhere. It's inside of your energy, and this recognizes your guardian. But in some cases, it's your lover. Some cases it can be that your lover has come back to be your guardian. It's possible. I've seen brothers or sisters like that, that they are your guardian. But even that, even if it's your relatives, it's still an urge that dragons have a lot. It can grow, it can come later. It's just something that you want. I, for my, for example, for me, since my dragon came, I didn't care about, much about humans. Humans actually never, it was never my thing. Actually never, not humans, not animals, not that, it's just nothing else. But the dragon was interesting me. Not my guardian, by the way, it was more like a mother figure. It felt like my mother, a very strict mother, by the way, a very strict one, but still a mother. But if I opened the dragon's gate to the dragon's realms and felt all of these dragons, yes, that is beautiful. That is just this energy, this urge, that is, yeah, I felt that. And maybe this is taboo to say something like that, but I don't want to have taboo in this. We are a left-hand path, which means no taboo, no dogma, nothing that can tell us what to do. So if I can tell you my feelings when I felt the dragon's gate and the dragon's realms, then I want to tell you everything about this and what I felt. And this is what I felt, this attraction, pure on the dragon's energies. But my guardian is more like, yeah, like I said, a mother. A beautiful one. Actually, I'm just looking at her. And it also means that your gender energy will constantly change. Because your energy will also, will, most of the time, the energy that we have inside of us have a different gender energy than us, than we. I'm a male, well, I want to say. And this actually, when the dragon can also come inside of you, and every time this happens, this energy will change a bit more. And it's all a whirlpool of energies. It will all be just male, female. It's not keeping just the same thing. It's just, sometimes my brothers and sisters say that they have no energy of gender, but I feel they have this energy a lot. It's just shifting all the time, shifting. That is why I call sometimes my dragon he, and sometimes she. That we are actually exchanging energies. But to come back to this, sex energy, draconic sex energy is a very, very strong. It immediately opens a lot of gates, so many gates. I mean, when you have your mind fixed on the dragon while you have sexual acts, that is pure magic with a CK in the end, and very, very strong magic if you do this. But your eyes have to be directed on the dragon, your mind as well. Your mind is the key to everything. If your mind has this satisfaction and this energy while your mind is on the dragon, that opens gates, my brothers and sisters. If you can have this, if you have this feeling of this. Not all of my brothers and sisters have this feeling, not all of them, but some of them. Maybe you can try it out. Maybe you can feel this energy. Maybe you can feel also this attraction towards the dragon. That is, that this can be have several energies, several reasons why you can be attracted to the dragon. It can be because it's your mother, my mother, my dragon, you know, my father. It can be like that. And you don't have any sexual in things like sexual feelings for the dragon. That can be, of course. Or you have it just like a lot of other brothers and sisters have. I've seen that there are people, my brothers and sisters, who have this as a main issue on their path. I've seen this so many times, and I felt this so many times. So no taboo. Don't be afraid of this. If you want to keep your mind on the dragon while you have sexual acts while your mind is on the dragon. Then please open the gates. Open the gates with it. Don't let it go to waste. And let the gates open with it. No taboo. Forget the world. Like I said before, magic is the bloodstream of everything you see. Forget all you know or think you know. All you need is your intuition and your feelings. My brothers and sisters, be blessed.